Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers. This is your host welcoming you to your daily edition of the Cricket Happening Show. And on this particular Cricket Happening Show, well, there is one match which is happening. It is happening between Zimbabwe versus Ireland. And I can tell you, Zimbabwe would be very happy here, as Ireland were looking on, or probably on course for a victory. But Sikandar Razak keeping his cool and guiding the Zimbabweans to a beautiful victory here, as Sikandar Razak was unbeaten on 60 of 72 balls with 4 fours. A very good effort from Sikandar Razak. He really saw to it that he could. He stayed there. He knew that his wicket was very, very important if at all Zimbabwe had to win, and that's what precisely Sikandar Razak did and piloted them to victory with one over to spare. So Ireland 219 for 8 batting first. Defeated by Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe winning the match by 2 wickets, making 222 for 8 of 49 overs. The other thing that I'll be looking at is England 11, in fact, had a very tough time. Yesterday we saw that the England 11 bowlers bowled out the Pakistani A for 192, in the sense they restricted them to 192 for 9. And today England had a very, very, I would say this was not something that England would have expected. Because even if you see the Pakistani bowling attack, it is the Pakistan A team which is playing. And the Pakistan A team created havoc in the England camp today when they reduced them to 198 for 9 with Mir Hamza capturing 4 wickets for 34 runs, supported by Junaid Khan 2 for 28, 2 for 47 for Zafar Gohar, the left-arm spinner, and 1 wicket apiece to Mohammad Asghar and Iftikhar Ahmed. So I'll be talking about that particular match in very brief. And also, as you know, West Indies are touring Sri Lanka, and they played their first tour game. And I'm afraid to say that stumps on day one, the West Indians were looking pretty ragged at 127 for 6, again, playing against the Sri Lankan President 11. And for Sri Lankan President 11, it was Lakmal doing a good job, and also the forgotten off-spinner from Sri Lanka, the tall Masura Ranadive. Well, I'm going to talk about all that in brief, but first we will look at the Zimbabwe versus Ireland match and see what really panned out. This happened at the Harare Sports Club. So Ireland batting first, made 219 for 8 of their 50 overs. If you look at the scorecard there, they had good contributions coming. The highest scorer was Gary Wilson, who almost, I mean, this is the role that I would say that Sikandar Razak played. I mean, if you look at it, it has a real similarity. The only difference being that Sikandar Razak finishing on the winning side, but for Gary Wilson, even though he contributed an unbeaten 70 of 88 deliveries with 4 fours, he finished on the losing side. So Zimbabwe were the ones been, and also there was a debut today for the, as you know, Hamilton Masakadza has been left out because of poor form, which I'm not really, really happy about, because I thought Hamilton Masakadza is a very good player. I mean, he's the most experienced player in the team, with considering that we don't have Brendan Taylor anymore playing for Zimbabwe. So I was a bit surprised. But his brother, the left-arm spinner Wellington Masakadza, today made his debut and also got 2 wickets. But just talking about this, it was Gary Wilson who contributed an unbeaten 70 of 88 deliveries with 4 fours. Other contributions coming, 8 Joyce, a compact 53 of 88 deliveries with 2 fours and 1 6, 24 from the bat of Peter Sterling of as many balls with 5 fours. And then we saw Kevin O'Brien slap 16 of 15 balls with 2 fours. And at the end, we saw the all-rounder Andy McBride unbeaten on 23 of 14 deliveries with 2 fours and 1 6. Other than that, Porterfield collected only 9 runs, the captain of the team, out for 9 of 31 deliveries with 1 four. Balbiri could contribute only 5 of 23 balls. He scratched around the place, I would say. Shane Thompson was out for 1. Mooney was out for 5. Dockrell could contribute only 1. 219. Looking at the Zimbabwean bowling card there, Tasha Panea, in fact, I thought Zimbabwean bowling effort was pretty decent. 7 overs on made in 1 for 25 for Tanasha Panyangra. Luke Jongwe, 7 overs on for 45, was a bit costly. Chibaba rolled his arm over beautifully. 7 overs on made in 1 for 90. And I said, Chow Chibaba, he's not only a very good batsman, but he's also a very, very useful bowler. We have seen that he has been taking wickets, he has been delivering, and I think he's a very, very useful person as far as Zimbabwean squad is concerned. 7 overs, 1 made and 1 for 19. John Imbu, the random off spinner, completing a score of 10 overs, 32 for 35. Wellington Masakadze says that the brother of Hamilton Masakadze was dropped today. In fact, Wellington Masakadze making his one-day international debut, 10 overs, no made and 245. Sean Williams, 9 overs, no made and 1 for 45. As far as Zimbabwe is concerned, Zimbabwe definitely found that going tough as they started losing wickets at regular intervals. Chamu Shibaba contributed 22 of 26 balls with 3 fours. Mutumbami opening the innings with Shibaba made 9 of 14 balls, 2 fours. Craig Irvine contributing 16. In fact, Craig Irvine and Sukandar Raza were the joint scorers, highest scorers there in the victory. Craig Irvine contributing 60 of 78 balls with 5 fours. Sean Williams making 24 of 32 balls with 2 fours. 16 coming from the bat of Felton Shugumbra of 22 balls with 1 4. But Sikandar Raza was the binding force as far as Zimbabwe were concerned, because they were at a situation where they were 171 for 7 at one stage, and still the mark of 221 was pretty far off. But Sikandar Raza keeping a cool head and also deciding that he would eschew his stroke-making capability, where he decided to occupy the crease, and he needed some support from the Zimbabwean tail-enders, which came in the form of Wellington Masakadze, who made his debut, contributed 10 useful runs of 18 balls. Tanasha Panyangra, 8 of 11 balls with 1-4, not out. Malcolm Waller was out for 1. Jongwe, unfortunately, run out, but Sikandar Raza keeping his cool, guiding his team to victory, and Zimbabwe winning the match here and also leading the three-match series by 1-0, with Sikandar Raza contributing an unbeaten 60 of 72 balls with 4 fours, a winning knock from him. And looking at the bowling part for the Irish bowlers there, John Mooney, 5 overs, 1 minute and 1 for 24. Muttagg was a bit costly, 10 overs, 1 for 52. Andy McBrien, the off-spinner, 10 overs, no made and 2 for 53. Sterling, 10 overs for 35, was pretty economical. Dockrell bowled excellently, 10 overs, no made and 229. Kevin O'Brien, 4 overs, which cost him 24 runs. So player of the match, without any doubt, was Sikandar Raza of Zimbabwe. And Zimbabwe are leading the three-match series now at 1-0. So Zimbabwe Zimbabwe would be pretty happy with this effort that they put against the Irish bowlers here. Now let's look at some tour matches here. As you know, England are going to play Pakistan in the Test matches. And now yesterday there was the match which was going on. Pakistan, as I said, they were restricted by England. But one never thought that England 11 would be, and especially considering that the Test match is round the corner now, I think England could have played much better than what they did, because England 11, 198 for 9 in reply. The match was drawn, but 198 for 9 in reply. If you look at the card there for England, doesn't make any happy reading. Barring Ian Bell, who retired not out 53 with 4 fours and 1 6, and James Taylor 61 with 6 boundaries. Butler contributed 39. Moeen Ali making 20 with 1 4 and 1 6. Hayes was out for 9. Ben Stokes was dismissed for naught. And after that, Sameer Patel for 8. Jonathan Bairstow for naught. Rashid for 2. And Plunkett for 1. 198 for 9. And the bowling, as I said, Mir Hamza going through the England camp in a very, very nice manner. In fact, picking up 4 wickets for 34 with 16 overs and 4 maidens. Junaid Khan, 12 overs, 1 maiden, 2 for 28. 2 for 47 for the left-arm spinner Zafar Gohar. And 1 wicket apiece, as I said, Mohammad Asghar and Iftikhar Ahmed. So that is as far as that match is concerned. As we also know, West Indies are touring Sri Lanka. They are also going to play a few in one-day internationals and a test series there. And West Indies, as I said, stumps on day 1 against the Sri Lanka Board President's 11, their first tour game after coming to Sri Lanka. Had them in a very, very solid state there, as they finished at 127 for 6 on a rain hit day here at the Sinhalese Sports Club here in Colombo. West Indians really, really found their going pretty, pretty tough. They found that the Sri Lankan bowling was something which was really good. First, it was Sringa Lakmal, who picked up 2 wickets for 10 runs, 11 overs, 4 maidens. And Suraj Andave, the off-spinner from Sri Lanka, who nowadays we don't see him as a regular, 30 knows to Ministry for 33. He was also called for checking, I mean, called for a suspect action, but he was clear, I suppose. 30 knows to Ministry for 33 for him, and one wicket to MVT Fernando. As far as the West Indians were concerned, Brathwaite was the highest scorer at the top with 46 with 6 boundaries. Chandrika, who played against Australia, as we know, he made his debut against Australia in the Test matches in the West Indies, made 18 of the 3 boundaries. Darren Bravo making 21 with 3 fours and 1 6. Marlon Samuels collected a knot. Blackwood was out cheaply for 3. Shai Hope, who is a good talent emerging from the West Indian island, I would say, because Shai Hope, we have seen that he's one who has who also made his debut against Australia. Looked impressive, and he was there at stumps, not out on 24 with 3 boundaries. Dowrich was out for 3. Ramadan not out on 5. 127 for 6 was out. West Indies ended up on their first tour game here and on the tour of Sri Lanka. And I wouldn't say West Indies would be very happy with this effort. Well, dear fans, friends, subscribers, I think today it's time for me to say goodbye on this cricket show on Cricket Happenings. But Saturday, it's going to be a late night cricket show, as you all know. But I will have to tell you, the cricket show might be pretty late. Maybe not coming at the original time. I have some other chores to catch up with tomorrow after my office. So I will be probably coming back to you, dear fans and subscribers, probably late at night here. But nevertheless, the cricket show rages on, I mean, goes on. As you know, the cricket show never ends. So it would be there. So you can still keep an eye on this particular Cricket Happening show. You would find me talking on Cricket Happenings tomorrow. Till such time, I see you tomorrow. That's on a late night cricket show on Saturday. This is your host, Ram, bidding goodbye for the day. Thank you.